to be and stirred inside their heart. Our uniting time has come, we and the Father are one. Soon we'll be with our Lord forevermore. The evening light is come, the bride is making preparation. She's hearing the shout of the king. The token's been applied, it's cleaning from inside. And the dove leaves the lamb once again.
Finally, put me in subjection for his glory. That when somebody will see me on the street, they'll say, there's a Christian. Not by the clothes I wear, or not by the things I do, but by my nature, by the way that I act. When I tell them I love you, and I care about you, and I'm praying for your family. You ever told a sinner that you're praying for them? Well, buddy, they'll just butt at this bit. They'll get all melancholy.
Yeah.
Well, you ever notice that? Well, you really? Maybe you. I told the man that goes to church the other night, yeah, I'd pray for him. He went, My. Post after the baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Buddy, if a Church of Christ fellow told me he was going to pray for me, I'd say, pray on, brother.
Yeah.
If a Catholic told me he was going to pray for me, I'd say, you pray on. Because I don't know who the bride of Christ is, and that man may move up someday. Again, amen. Amen. I'm telling you, the guy did, and I still call him my brother. And I love him, and we're friends. But I was packed one out of the hospital. And I said, who's here? And he said, so-and-so. And I said, I hate that. I said, but I'll pray for him. And I'm telling you, the brother went, Like, God, we can't pray down here. You think about that. And then I told y'all the story. There's a lady who lives totally contrary to the way that I live in the flesh. But she's a really good person. God impressed on me to have her pray for my wife, and my wife had 100% turnaround. God is God.
That's right.
I can't question it. I don't want to question it. The only thing I know is my wife needs me in the well, and he met her at the well. He touched her. He brought her. Amen to God. Yes, he will. That's the God I serve.
Amen.
I don't serve no cracking whip God up there that hates me, don't want me to do nothing, don't want me to go nowhere. He just wants me to take him with me.
Amen.
Take him with me. If I go somewhere, he just wants to go.
Right.
Amen, because he loves me. And he wants to keep me out of harm's way. Amen, it ain't no, I got to do this, I got to do that. I have to submit myself to the tender hand of God. Let him meet me at the well, and he'll show me everything that I need to know.
Amen.
He showed this Rebecca. He's got to show me.
That's right.
Now, like this one right here. Eliezer gives her the signet. Listen. Genesis 24:22. And it came to pass, as the camels had done drinking, that the man took a gold earring. Look at me. He took an earring. What body part did it? The ear. The hearing part.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Of a half a shekel weight and two bracelets for her hands. She accepted the word and took the right hand of fellowship with Jesus Christ. My God, again. And you know what about those things, those two pieces of jewelry? That was already hers when the artificer was banging on them and was clanging on them and was molding them and making them an ear shackle and making those braces. They were already Rebecca's.
Yeah.
They were already hers. She was the heir of promise.
Mm-hmm,
the heir of promise. She was already banging on them things. And when he clicked them things around her wrist, and when she clicked them things in her heels, she might have got just a little quiver of the Holy Ghost.
Yeah. Amen.
I can't say for sure, But I know that John the Baptist slept in his mother's womb when she heard the salutation of Mary.
Yes, sir.
That's right.
You don't think that that meant something to her? A little old girl just walking along. You know what he gave them to her for? Because her character. Her character. He said, let the one that lets down the water and gives me a drink and gives my camels a drink, let her be the one. Well, the angel of the Lord down here, she come. She said, let me lay down my water pot for you. Let me give your camels drink. Let me give them provender. It was her character. It was her character that got a hold of Eliezer. And that's your character that got a hold of God. It wasn't nothing you done in the flesh. It wasn't the way you walked. It wasn't the way you looked. How much money you had. How much money you didn't have. But it was your character.
Yes, sir.
That when he needed a drink, you would have offered it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I like that part about them things already being made. It's not a lie, is it?
Yeah,
that's right. See, that's the other part of the book of Hebrews. It talks about an oath of confirmation. That's what me and Lil go after. It was a promise. It was a promise when she got them things that she was different now. There was something about her, Sister Kathy, that this man gave her this earring and them two gold bracelets. She could never, ever go back.
Amen.
She didn't want to go back. She didn't want to go back. She received a signet. She listened and she got that fellowship. My. I like how Jamie says that boy about making shower. Alright, listen to this. The door we're going to close in a minute. God help us. And Eliezer gives silver, gold, and raiment to Rebecca. I can't tell you, I think this may be verse 23. And the servant brought forth jewels of silver, jewels of gold, and raiment. Hold on to that raiment, okay? I want you to hold on to that. And just keep that in the back of your mind. Raiment, okay? And he gave them to Rebecca. And he also gave them to her brother and to her mother, precious things. You see, there goes the doctrine of once in grace, always in grace. See, God's always got a way around foolishness and false doctrine, right? He gave all his gifts to men. Whosoever will, let him come and take of the waters of life freely. He just knows who will and who won't. But yet he offers. Daily.
Yeah.
On billboard signs. A lot of people think he thinks it's hoax, but hey, I'm telling you what, if it says something about God, he's offering.
Yeah.
When they see a Christian or they see a Bible sitting in a hospital waiting room or in a hotel room, he's offering.
Yeah.
He's offering. What'll happen? They'll reject it. But the bride, she'll pick it up and thumb through it. And she'll say, I don't know what this is, but I want to know. I want to know what this is.
Right.
And she'll find a way to find out exactly what it says.
Uh-huh.
She'll go to seminary. She'll study. She'll go to PhD and LLD. But the main thing is, when she gets to the point, she'll realize that I can't find out.
That's right.
He'll send Eliezer by her way.
Amen.
He'll send the Holy Ghost by her way and reveal that book to her.
Amen.
Whosoever will, let him come and take of the waters of life freely. Whosoever will, their hands always offer. But there's just a few. Our writers told us that. Wide is the way to destruction, but narrow is the way to life. Many there be that get on the wide way. Few there be that find the narrow way. Right?
Yeah.
Rebecca's free will moral agency. She had to choose. Listen to this. And this is verse 54. And they did eat and drink, he and the men that were with him, and tarried all night. And they teeth, now I'm going to give you, he had already asked for Rebecca, okay? They had already said, take her and go. Rose up early in the morning and said, send me away unto my master. And her mother, her brother and her mother said, "Let the damsel abide with us a few days, at the least 10. After that she shall go." And he said unto them, "Hinder me not, seeing the Lord hath prospered my way. Send me away that I may go to my master." And they said, "We will call the damsel and inquire at her mouth." They're going to ask her. There's just a difference here. They wanted to stay in Mesopotamia. They liked the gifts that old Eliezer brought. They liked that old speaking in tongues. They liked that old baptism of the Holy. They liked that old shouting, Rick. They liked getting hands laid on them, and they liked being healed. They liked the prayer lines. They liked discernment. They liked all those things, but they didn't want to leave Mesopotamia.
That's right.
They wanted to stay in Mesopotamia. They wanted to stay in the Methodist. They wanted to stay in Mesopotamia. They wanted to stay in Pentecost. I mean in Mesopotamia.
Right.
You understand what I'm telling you?
Amen.
They did not want to leave their pre-organized denomination.
That's right.
And you can say, "I'm not a denomination because I don't have the nominal head." But if you conquer that laity, if you make yourself higher than the laity and you conquer them, you're a part of that whore.
That's
right. Of Revelation 17.
Amen.
They didn't want to leave. But they said, "Let us inquire at the damsel." This is where you come in. I don't even have to look at it. She said, "This ought to make you shout." By the time I get here, Donna gets so worked up. And every time I get here, I'm so tired, I can't hardly. You know what she said? "I will go."
Yeah.
No hesitation. Well, not maybe that sounds right, but I don't know. Boy, that sounds good. But buddy, when she seen something in the Word, she said, "I gotta go, more or less. I can't stay here with you fellas no more. I got two signets on my hand. I got something on my ear. Something's made me different, and I gotta go. I can't stay here no more. I love you. She wasn't satisfied with the ring and the earring. She wanted to go where they was. She wanted to go where all of that stuff was. She was getting on a part of it. She was into all of it. She wanted every bit of it. She didn't want just a little bit, Brother Jamie. My God, I want it all. Because I was called from the foundation of the world.
Amen.
I was called by God to those things.
Amen.
I'm an heir of the promise.
Amen.
Of His immutable counsel.
Amen.
By that oath. That if I come out from among them and be me servant, I'm tossed up that unclean thing, I will be His son.
Amen.
He will be my God. I will be some of His people. My. I bet y'all wish I'd never start working out. Lord, I agree with you. Not because I'm doing it. Give me my hand plate, guys. Just a few more minutes of your time, okay? Just a few more minutes. Because these brothers know what I'm talking about. When you don't need to preach, you know, if we was preaching consecutive nights, we could cut it off right here and pick back up. But I believe God wants you to have just this little bit, okay? My God, this will just bless you. I'm telling you. I know that bless you. It's all. It ain't because I'm preaching. It's not. Verse 61. The journey. The messenger and the bride. Woo! And Rebecca arose and her damsels. Our church folk that believe just like she did. Everybody that had that mutual faith, just like she did. Everybody that said, I want to go, just like she did. The Mesopotamia wasn't enough for them. She gotta go.
Amen.
And Rebecca rose and her damsels, and they rode upon the camels and followed the man. Followed the man.
Yes.
That's thus saith the Lord, people.
Amen.
Not the woman, yeah, the man.
That's right.
And amen.
Amen.
A prophet, an apostle, an evangelist, a pastor, and a teacher who what? Got their call before the foundation of the world.
Amen. Amen.
Jeremiah said, God, who has ordained me a prophet before the foundation of the world. She wants to know what the word says, but she can only be taught by a man.
That's right.
And us men got to submit ourselves to other men. And then those men got to submit themselves to God. Right?
Yeah.
See, she had to be taught on the way. Check this out. The journey. The journey, brothers and sisters, is finding out, sister, what he looks like, who he is, all his likes, all his dislikes, what he gave you, what he's going to give you. That's the journey. And that's what we find out along the way. On day one.